Sarah now replaced her position. No matter who a maid is to the mistress, you don't have any right if you sleep with your mistress master. You have defied. Sarah took herself, defied her future. Soiled her. It was Sarah actually that orchestrated for their children to suffer under the Egyptian for 400 years. She removed her position as Israelite, the mother of Israel, and gave the blessing to who? Mother of Egypt. And when Hannah had a man, what did Abraham do? Abraham entered into the altar of the Egyptian to worship. Instead of worship, do you know your relationship with your wife is altar? The word that God has said this. He said, he that findeth a man findeth a good thing. I mean, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing. God is giving you an altar, you should be entering. Don't enter any other altar. To worship. And Sarah introduced another altar. I said, Abraham, go and worship in that altar. And God said, you are going to make a mistake. Why I see you? You are so desperate. You are going to worship in Egyptian altar. And when you go and worship there, you will be bound. Your children will be bound. And before they will come out, it will take more than 400 years. And Abraham was not interested. Abraham did not check whether what Sarah was telling him or what Sarah asked him to do was in line with the will of Jehovah or was in line with the promises of Jehovah. Remember, God has promised him, this one child that you are looking for, through him all the nations shall be blessed. And definitely, Abraham, I cannot disappoint you. But when he saw the desperateness of Abraham, because God hides a matter, it takes a king to discover the matter. And he warned Abraham. See, alarm, alarm. That's why I said your eyes will see, but you need an alert, antivirus. Abraham could not understand the warning. He was desperate. He wasn't interested that his children was going to suffer 400 years. When the process started, Sarah said, I'm no more the place you worship. Worship the goddess of Egypt. The Bible said Abraham obeyed the wife. This is unrealistic of the world's realities. What was the thing that makes it world reality? Jehovah was not in it. His promises were not in it. What is it that you are doing in life? What is that assignment? That is why I've lived in overseas. I've not gone to any pub. I've not gone to any club. I don't know. On the last day you see it, everything shall be made of you. You know whether I'm lying or telling the truth. Why? Any one of them I want to do is Jehovah involved. You see where I came from. I came from the poorest, one of the poorest cities. I came from one of the poorest families. Will I come this far and still not go home with a testimony? And the only way I will succeed, the only thing that will make it real, realizable, is marrying Jehovah and his word. Abraham accepted and he entered into the altar. And what is seed? He sowed a seed. What does that mean? He sowed his life. At the altar of Egyptian goddess, Hagar, and he gave his life. Yeah, his future. And later, Sarah bared him a child. The seed grew and became. Do you know how stubborn Abraham was? Even when he got this, go to 17 verse 17. Let me show you something. Look at this. God told him, read 17 verse 15. Start from 17, 15.
And God said unto Abraham,
listen very well.
As for Sarai, thy wife.
As for Sarai, thy wife, even though you have made a mistake, even though you have locked the future, you have promoted the goddess of Egypt that the wife has given unto you.
Thou shalt not call her name Sarai, but Sarah shall her name be. And I will bless her and give thee a son also of her. I will bless her.
Continue.
And she shall be a mother of nations.
Okay.
Kings of people shall be of her.
The promises of the Lord is without repentance. The gift of the Lord is without continuity.
Then Abraham...
Look at what Abraham... Even after God came back again, Abraham made a mistake. God came to Abraham chapter 15. The temptation came to chapter 17, 16. Abraham fell into it. God still came back. I said, Abraham, you have made a mistake. You have bondage your children. Do you look at the request of Abraham in 17? Go, listen.
Then Abraham fell upon his face.
Abraham laughed. He took one big cigarette and took one bottle of beer and drank and said, look at what he said.
And laughed.
And laughed. Look at this man talking. How many years since I was 75 years, you have been promising me a child. Now that I have unrealistic of the world realities, now I'm starting seeing realities. Now I'm starting seeing a child. Now I'm starting seeing success. But Abraham did not know he's unrealistic of the world's reality.
And said in his heart, shall a child be born unto him that is 100 years old? And shall Sarah that is 90 years old? And Abraham said unto God.
Listen now, look at the next request he made. Continue.
Oh, that Ishmael might live before thee.
He said, God, stop. Your story is too much. Every year you come with the same story. I beg, can you please just bless Ishmael for me?
And God said, Sarah, thy wife shall bear thee a son.
God still repeated, my covenant with you I cannot break. I entered it into you, to you with you, not you entering into me. And I cannot lie.
And thou shalt call his name Isaac.
Listen very well. God, now listen now. God has said, repeated, he said, is Isaac is still the seed. Now look at what God has said now. He started blessing Ishmael.
And I will establish my covenant with him, an everlasting covenant. With this and with his seed after him. And as for Ishmael.
As for Ishmael.
I have heard thee. Behold, I have blessed him. And will make him fruitful.
I will make it fruitful.
And will multiply him exceedingly.
How many tribes? Continue.
12 princes.
The 12 princes.
Shall he be given?
Now listen now. Listen very, very well. This same mistake that Abraham made is what is causing the ICIC throwing bomb, all these Islamic fanatics. Because that is why, you know, I watch people, they are going to stop the Islam, they are going to stop the Muslim Islamization of this. It cannot happen. God say, I've already blessed them to do that. Say, through the sword, Ishmael shall live. Ishmael is the foundation of Islam. Ishmael is Islam we are talking about. Ishmael is Islam. Now think about it. What if Abraham has kept his penis? What if Abraham had not worshipped in the altar of the goddess of Egyptian? Do you know how peaceful this world would have been? Do you know how peaceful this world would have been? The problem would have been happening because all these other religions, they are far from Christianity. They are not, they don't get angry. Christians are infidels to them. It's not really other religion, they are not infidels to them. It's only Christians. How did it come to pass? God warned Abraham. If God said 400 years, in as much as they suffer 430 years. But a day before God is 100 years. It's 1,000 years. That was how Islam came. Ishmael is the beginning of Islam. And that is why Islam is the only religion. You know, Christianity, Islam, they have almost the same foundation. Quran and the Bible. And the people that are really practicing it very well are the Sierra Leoneans. They don't want anything to happen to Ishmael. They don't want anything to happen. They don't want Isaac and Ishmael to have problems. Isaac is okay, doesn't want. But they are doing very well. I don't know how they are managing it. Both the 12 tribe of Ishmael enjoy Sierra Leone. The 12 tribe of Israel, they enjoy Sierra Leone. They marry, they don't have any issue. You don't preach against Christians, you don't preach against. I wonder how Ishmael and Isaac did that. That's how it started. Unrealistic of the world's reality. Well, how was the mistake? God empowered Sarah, mother of nations. He said, whatever you speak to my ears, it will happen. And God empowered Abraham and said, two of you, go and build me a powerful nation called Isaac. Along the way, because of desperation, because they wanted it fast. And the devil promised them, through Sarah. They said, there's a reality. But they didn't check whether God was with them. And Sarah used her power, authority, established her. We will serve him. You are now the mother of this house. You are now the wife that God has approved. Sleep with my husband. And Abraham, you know, to show his desperate. Look at him, he's desperate, but he's pretending. Yeah, he's saying I should do it. Push me small, let me go and do it. Push me so that you know it's you that did it. Sarah, push you, I beg, go and give me a son. The Bible says, immediately Hagar slept with Abraham, tested the power and authority. He started to despise Sarah. Can you give a child? You can't give a child. You can't give birth to a child. You are supposed to be my maid. And Abraham went, and Sarah went to Abraham and said, Abraham said, it was your fault. You say, he said, no, it's you. You slept with her. Get impregnate her. You can't impregnate me. You know women. And Abraham said, she's your maid. Do whatever you want to do. The power is with you. She sent her out. Church, I'm here to tell you, unrealistic of the world realities can come even through a born-again Christian that you married to, your wife or your husband. The only way to escape from this, I'll keep on teaching this message for how many months? 6 months. And I'll keep on repeating one thing. How will you escape from this? Check whether Jehovah is involved. Check whether the promises of Jehovah are involved. If these two are not involved, it is unrealistic. You can never realize it, no matter how real it might look. For without God, you can do absolutely nothing. That was how Abraham initiated the problems, the major battle that Christianity is having today. Not as if God did not want him. God warned him, but it is the glory of God to hide their matter. God cannot change his nature. He will always hide it. If it has happened to me, there are dreams. When God showed me about this Nnamdi Kanu, I didn't understand it until after 1 year. I kept on praying. I said, God, I don't want to make a mistake. Reveal to me what you're showing me. What does this dream mean? And you know how God hid it? My wife was pregnant, and I was asking God, thanking God, for giving me a male child. The next thing I saw, he gave me, and in the dream, while the guy was giving his speech as the new leader, he said, Pastor Joseph, before you go, so he knew me. We are related. He said, before you go, final scripture, Genesis chapter 18, verse 10. And where he said, by this time, according to Tamar, I shall return. And Sarah, your wife, shall have a son. I woke up, I thought to my wife, I had a dream now. I said, we are going to have two sons. So now you relax. No more disturbing me for more children. Now you are giving, you are going to have a son. I believed it in that dream. That was on 10th of June, 2015. I called my wife. I've seen it in the dream. But one thing about God, if God gives you a dream, and he's talking about something physical, and it didn't happen that way, know that that dream is beyond physical. Because the word of God goes beyond physical. It has no boundary. It can go beyond. It can even go after death. It can even happen after death if somebody dies and the revelation will happen. If you are sure it's from God, it will still bring that person back to be fulfilled. I'm telling you the truth. You don't know this God we are talking about. And that's how your faith. It was after 1 year, after Noah, it was on the 24th of October, 2015. I was watching the news and they were interviewing Gowan, former, the man that is leading all this evil, the man that started this evil, the man that agreed with the British to unleash this evil upon Biafra. That was when he now said, no, Biafra is dead. I said, my wife, fucking it, this man is saying something. The next day, the whole dream, as it was on that June, 10th of June, came back to my grind. So, that interview, if I have not gotten that interview, I wouldn't have gotten the trace to explain the dream. I told my wife, I started understanding that dream, because now my children are going to be born. We have found out that we have 2 girls. So I told my wife, this dream is beyond having boys. Something is about to happen. And that was why when people asked me, I said I went to God after starting Church of God Mission. The next thing he told me is this dream. Told me about Biafra. People have called me names. I'm not just, it took me 1 year before I found out that it was, this dream was talking about Nnamdi Kanu. That God is going to give Biafra a son. A Biafra son that he's going to use. That is why I keep on telling people, Nnamdi Kanu is not there because he's in Nnamdi Kanu. He has been chosen from the foundation of the earth. God didn't choose me. He chose him. He made his choices. God keep on hiding things. He came to my father Abraham and said, your children are going to suffer. Abraham did not care about it. All he wanted is to have a child. In his desperation, look at what we are passing through. I pray that when you're seeking for your reality, when you're seeking for what you want, the success you want in life, you will not make the mistake of Abraham. Amen. You see his faith has blessed us, but also his mistake is killing us. Amen. That one mistake, and God came to warn him. May the Lord lift you above every mistake. May the Lord lift you above every marital mistake. May the Lord lift you above everything that will bring curse upon your life. It was said to Abraham, God did not hide it from Abraham. He said, the child you are looking for will only live for how many years? 100 years. But the future children will suffer for 400 years. Abraham, what the way you are looking for it, trying to realize it in a worldly way. Abraham did not give heed to it. Today is the major problem of his children, Isaac. Lord, I pray we will not proclaim that we are blessing our children, and we will also be the one that will create the problem they will face tomorrow. We cannot embondage our children in the future. Lord, the blessing you are giving to us is going to liberate us. We will wait until our change comes. We will not be in a hurry. Father, there is nothing real in heaven and on earth except you and your promises. We are ready, oh God, to test everything, every project, every activity, everything we are going to pass through in life until we see you in it, or see your promise in it. We shall not get involved. Help us, Lord. Give us that understanding. Help us with the right alert to know that there is danger. Sarah walked to her husband and said, we are desperate. Let's do this. And they brought a problem. In our pursuit for success, we shall not imprison our future. In our pursuit for success, we shall not bring curses upon our future. In our pursuit and desperation to get out of bondages and desperation, Lord, we will not make mistakes. We will not make mistakes that will handcuff our future, that will destroy our future. I'm here to tell you, church, anything you want to actualize, anything that the world has promised you that is real, that doesn't have Jehovah attached to it, that doesn't have the promises of God attached to it, be ready for a war. Be ready for a battle. Be ready for curses. Because the only thing that is real, the only thing that can, the Bible says, the blessings of the Lord make it rich and adds no sorrow to it. The only thing that will give you divine blessing, enduring wealth, sound peace, if it doesn't come from Jehovah, or it doesn't come from his promises, they will end in pieces. Lord, deliver us from ending in pieces. Amen. Help us to end in peace in the name of Jesus. Lord, I bless my hearers. I ask that the blood of Jesus will keep on speaking on their behalf. I ask, oh God, that anytime they want to move away from that way, the Bible says there's a way that seemeth right unto people, but the end thereof is death. Anyone that wants to make that mistake, Lord, I ask that the blood of Jesus will deliver them.
Amen.
We reveal to them that they are about to make a mistake that will conquer their generation. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, for what you have done. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, we now share the grace of fruit. Oh.